To rationalize the denominator of a radical expression, we want to eliminate the radical from the denominator. And when the denominator contains a sum or difference involving a square root, as we see here, we're going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of the denominator. So for our first example, since the denominator is 3 plus square root 7, we're going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by 3 minus square root 7. And to help remind us how to multiply, I think it's helpful to put these in parentheses, as well as here. So in the numerator, we're going to distribute negative 2. So we'll have negative 2 times 3, that's negative 6. And then we'll have plus 2 square root of 7. And now in the denominator, we'll have four products. First, we'll have 3 times 3, that's 9. Then we'll have 3 times negative square root of 7, that's minus 3 square root of 7. Next we have positive square root of 7 times positive 3, that's plus 3 square root of 7. Notice how these two terms are opposites. And then we have positive square root of 7 times negative square root of 7, that'll be minus the square root of 7 times 7. Which, because we have two equal factors, will simplify. So looking at the numerator, we'll have negative 6 plus 2 square root 7. Now in the denominator, notice how the two middle terms again are opposites. So this simplifies to 0. Notice here we have the square root of 7 times 7, or the square root of 7 squared. So this simplifies to 7, so we have 9 minus 7, which is 2. Now we're not quite done yet, because the numerator and the denominator do share a common factor of 2. So we'll go ahead and factor a 2 out of the numerator. We'd have 2 times the quantity negative 3 plus square root 7 all over 2. And here we have 2 over 2, which simplifies to 1. So finally we have negative 3 plus square root 7. Let's take a look at our second example. So we're concerned about having this square root 3 in the denominator. And since we have a difference here, we'll multiply both the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of 9 minus square root 3, which would be 9 plus square root 3. And again, we'll put everything in parentheses to help us multiply correctly. So now we'll have four products in the numerator as well as the denominator. So we'll have 3 times 9, that's 27. Then 3 times square root 3, that's 3 square root 3. Negative square root 2 times 9, that's minus 9 square root 2. And then we have negative square root 2 times positive square root 3, that's minus square root 2 times 3, or square root 6. And now in the denominator, we'll have 9 times 9, that's 81. And then 9 times square root 3, that's plus 9 square root 3. Next we have negative square root 3 times positive 9, which is minus 9 square root 3. Again, notice how we have opposites here. And then for the last product, we have negative square root 3 times positive square root 3, which would be minus the square root of 3 times 3, which we can see is a perfect square, and we'll simplify to 3. Now looking at the numerator, notice how there are no like radicands, and nothing simplifies, so nothing's going to change here. And then for the denominator, again, these two terms are opposites, that would be 0. So we have 81 minus the square root of 3 squared, or just minus 3, which would be 78. So this really does not seem simplified, but notice how the denominator no longer contains a square root. So the denominator is rationalized. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.